it looks like that the things that we relate to concussion in our calculations are completely separate from traumatic brain injury. They're two separate entities.
Whether it was an impact or a blast, it was causing the trauma. With support from our computational work, we're able to dig down and see the physics for potential cause of that difference.
And that's a very important finding. What we were trying to do was follow on previous work that we had done. We were simulating the experiments that Lee Goldstein, the principal author in the work, had done, that it was head motion from blast that gave rise to chronic traumatic encephalopathy. Previous experiments and work for years and years and years had maintained a fixed head and the blast would travel over the head, but no one could find any resulting brain injury from that.
The experiments were set up to have the same response, the same head motion to both an impact trauma and blast trauma.
After blast, there was no concussion, yet concussion with impact for the same motion.
And so the question was, what is there in the loading that could potentially cause that difference?
And that was a bit of a mystery. This is the second study we've done with Lee Goldstein at Boston University's MD, PhD. We needed some way to assess what was happening inside the head, and the only way we could probe that was with computation.
And so we used the multiphysics computational tools here at Livermore and high performance computing to get in and simulate the two loading conditions.
There's no difference with the pressure in the brain, but we did notice a profound difference in the shear stress. These shear stresses occurred before there was any gross motion of the head.
That high shear region just doesn't move. It's just sort of stationary.
They persisted around the impact point, and I condensed it for a fast phone call to Lee. I called him up and said, Lee, look, this is what I think we have. And then there's silence at the other end of the phone. And I said, Lee, he goes, I think you may have uncovered the cause of concussion.
Getting into a better understanding of the causes of the trauma, the causes of the damage that can result from the trauma, could lead us to, in the future, develop perhaps better protections against, in particular in this case, impact loading, where you want to make sure that any helmet you design for an impact load does a very good job of spreading out the load as well as possible, so you don't get this high concentration of shear stress that leads to a concussion.
The more you learn about the causes of traumatic brain injury, the more you learn about how to treat it after it's occurred, prevent it from happening. It's the whole spectrum.